Welcome to Robotic Planet.
Robots, they're pretty cool, right? Dependable, tireless, and of growing concern. But before they become a little bit too good at 3D, let's look at how we can create our own 3D robots in Blender. But I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself. First, perhaps an introduction. My name is Louis Dumont, and I've been a professional artist since 2005, and I now run a small animation company called Formation. We produce animation for all manner of clients. Outside of my day-to-day, I like to work on passion projects, producing little animated vignettes, and have a particular fascination with robots. Because, I don't know, maybe I can relate to them emotionally. Anyway, back to the course. Yes, it is about robots, polymodeling, sub-D modeling, as well as setting up our own procedural materials and lighting. However, we won't be stopping there. We'll be walking through a full production of these little animated shorts, from concepting, rigging, animating, lighting, and even a little bit of compositing. This course is best suited for the intermediate 3D generalist that wants a taste of the full production process, a process that touches on some industry standards, but is made for the solo artist, and doesn't assume that you have super high-end equipment or access to vast storage or render facilities. There is an expectation that you are already somewhat familiar with Blender's interface and are aware of the basic toolsets. If you feel like brushing up, you might want to check out Zach's free Blender Beginner course, or the Blender Launchpad course if you want something a bit more in-depth. Okay, the course is split up into two parts. Part 1 is Basic Bot, part 2 is Fish Bot. Both parts are available now, with a bonus part being released later this year. But purchasing this course gives you access to all of that and any future updates. As the name suggests, we will be starting simple. In this part of the course, we will balance practical theory alongside the production of our first robot, Basic Bot. Before jumping into Blender, for those that are interested, we'll be talking through some methods to help with idea generation and robot design. This topic is quite subjective and there is no magic formula, but we will cover some useful techniques and tools that can help you concept and develop your own robot ideas. We will then open Blender and walk through the process of creating BasicBot from an initial sketch. Starting simple with a boxy design so as not to overcomplicate the theory we'll be covering. We'll start by blocking out the form and continue to build up details using straightforward polymodeling with Boolean operations, learning how to take advantage of the native modifiers and free add-ons to speed up our workflow. And with our modeling complete, we'll jump into materials, exploring procedural nodes in order to build up easily customizable materials that scale to any resolution. Throughout this process, we'll be creating handy node groups for scratch, edge, dirt, and roughness masks that we can easily reuse when creating new materials. For this course, we'll be mainly using Eevee to render. However, we will look at adapting these materials for cycles in case you really want to push the boat out with some high fidelity renders. Then it's on to rigging, where we will create a simple armature using our geometry as a guide for our bone placement, and then we will parent the objects to the bones and look at numerous ways to make our rig much more pleasing to work with, as well as touching on some automation techniques using drivers. We will then look at creating a quick startup animation for our basic bot. We will talk through the animation principles and how to use them to inject a little bit of life into our otherwise inert object. We'll also look at utilizing the Wiggle Bones add-on to give us some secondary animation with relatively little work on our behalf. And finally, we'll be completing our short animation by adding an environment, with scattered plants and rocks, refining our lighting and render setup, and also using Blender's built-in compositor to add a little bit of film-like qualities to our final image. An evolutionary step up from our basic bot is Fishbot. For this part, we will up our game and get a little bit more complex, not only with our method of modeling, but also with the functionality of our robot, with an arcade-like agile claw to grip onto things. For modeling, we'll be jumping into the world of subdivided surfaces for hard surface, exploring multiple methods of mixing bevel, crease, and sub-D modifiers to retain a low-res controllable base mesh with smooth facet-free curves. We'll then be able to use our library of assets created in part 1 to quickly populate our materials, making this chapter comparatively speedy. However, we will still look at creating unique materials along the way. Rigging for our fishbot is where we get considerably more involved. We will use more advanced solutions to create the mechanics for our bot, utilizing hooks, curves, and geometry nodes to create a self-contained system that, among other things, enables us to collapse the claw into the bot's body with a custom property, and have the claw arm segments auto-populate based on the position of the claw head. With our fancy rig setup, we will jump into layout and animation, this time working from a storyboard. We'll expand on the principles we covered with BasicBot to create a more engaging, loopable, animated short, ideal for sharing online. But that's not all. A future update will add breakdown-style videos for 4 more robots, each with a unique mechanic to explore. These videos will focus exclusively on the principles that differ from the first 2 robots in part 1 and 2. Throughout this course, we'll be using Blender, with the addition of a few native or free add-ons. In the Creating Robots chapter, we'll take advantage of a program called PureRef to collect together various pieces of imagery from online. We'll also briefly touch on Grease Pencil as a concept sketching tool, which benefits from having a graphics tablet of some sort, however is not strictly necessary as we do explore options for mouse and trackpad users as well. So, as long as you have a computer that can run Blender and connect to the internet, you're good to go. Each video includes English subtitles and is available for viewing offline if you want to watch things on the go. Each video also includes support files, so you can pick up pretty much from anywhere in the course. And if you have any questions, you can ask them underneath in the discussion section on each video, or in the CG Boost community. Also, we're launching the course with a fun little project file for the early birds, so if you jump into the course before August 16th, 2023, you get access to this photo studio scene that you can drop your robotic creations into and then hit render for an animated fashion shoot. This course has been about a year in the making, and I feel there is a lot of value and, more importantly, fun to be had throughout. And I'm really excited to see what robots you produce, particularly if you branch off and create your own unique robot designs. Okay, let's get building some bots.